Father God, we come right now in the presence of the Almighty Spirit, asking you, Father God, to breathe on me one more time. Oh, Father God, let the blessings flow from on high. Let your power come and impart in this place. Truly, Father God, we have come tonight in the presence of the Almighty Spirit, asking you, Father God, to have your way in this place right now. Oh, Father God, we need a spiritual blessing tonight. Somebody need a blessing through your word tonight. Somebody need to know, Father God, that through your word that they can be delivered from whatever they may be going through. Oh, Father God, we thank you for what you have done tonight. We thank you for waking us up this morning. We thank you for bringing us through this day. We thank you for going on our jobs and making it home, Father God. We thank you for traveling grace tonight, Father God. Oh, Father God, bless this church tonight. Bless this service tonight. Bless this prayer line in the absence of their pastor tonight. That we can come and just lift up your spirit tonight. We come, Father God, humbly at the foot of the cross, knowing that when Jesus is lifted up, Father God, children will be saved in the name of Jesus. Oh, Father God, you are the potter, we are the clay. Have your own way right now. And we thank you, Father God, for what has been done and said up to this point. That as we move forward with your word, Father God, somebody will be spiritually blessed. Somebody will receive some power from on high. We know, Father God, through your word, Father God, we can be changed. We can be changed, Father God, in a moment of an eye. We know, Father God, that you can do all things. There's nothing impossible that you can do. And this is our prayer in Jesus' name. That the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in thy sight. Oh Lord, our strength and our Redeemer. And the church of God said amen.
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 Truly, I want to say thank you to this church for inviting us. You didn't have to, and we didn't have to say we would come. Amen. But we're here because we love Jesus.
Amen.
Come on down, young man. You hear, because we love Jesus. I don't know about you, but I love the Lord. I love the Lord because he heard my cry and pitied my every groan. Anybody ever groan? Anybody in here ever know that when you in trouble, you need to call on Jesus? Huh? When you feeling down, you need to call on Jesus. I like Reverend James. She always says, Pastor, I just don't feel like it sometimes. But when she get here, she seemed to have more spunk. That's nobody but the Lord. Huh? That God will strengthen you, church. Huh? He will strength that you didn't think you had. He'll give it to you just when you need it most. You heard how people say they lift up a car under normal conditions, but they're just trying to lift up a car. You can't lift up a car. But that danger comes. Huh? Let that car be about to crush you to death. And somehow you'll get that extra burst to lift that car and save a life. See, that's what God can do. So if he can give people strength to lift a car, he will definitely give you strength to come to the house of the Lord. Amen, amen. I know y'all didn't come to hear all that. But listen, I just want to thank y'all for inviting me again. And what's your name?
Ezekiel
Griffin.
Amen.
I know of Ezekiel Griffin, but that's not the one I know. Amen. I know the dad. Amen. That's the dad. Amen, amen, amen. You know, when we were at Kissimmee High School, had a relationship with St. Cloud, but then when segregation came and a lot of old faces, I remember the faces, but sometimes I forget the names. But truly, those names still are in my mind. But it's just been good to see the offsprings of those names. And I've been to some funerals of the matriarchs and patriarchs of those names out here, and you get to see the siblings, and you get to see people that we haven't seen in a long time, but still, God is still in the blessing business.
Yes,
and we all are one family of God.
Amen.
Listen, we don't want to hold you long, and good to have Pastor Perry here with us.
Amen.
He set up his system for us tonight, and and he has us on camera. I don't care if Pastor Perry is, we're going to be on camera. Amen. But that's all right, because we need to preach this word and take it all over the world. But I want you to go to the Gospel of Luke, chapter 6. The Gospel of Luke, chapter 6. And all the way over to verse 46 through 49. Familiar scripture. We're going to try to work with that. You stand to your feet, just read those three verses. It says, y'all with me?
Yes.
And why call ye me Lord, Lord, and do not the things which I say? Whosoever cometh to me and heareth my saying and doeth them, I will show you to whom he is like. He is like a man which built an house and digged deep and laid a foundation on a rock. And when the flood arose, the stream beat vehemently upon that house and could not shake it, for it was founded upon a rock. But he that heareth and doeth not is like a man that without a foundation built an house upon the earth, against which the stream did beat vehemently, and immediately it fell, and ruin, and the ruin of that house was great.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
You may be seated. From verse 49, but he that heareth and doeth not is like a man without a foundation built a house upon the earth. But what we want to say, but verse 46, that's what we want to be. And could not shake it, for it was founded upon a rock.
All right. I want to talk to you tonight from this subject, a solid foundation.
All right, man. A solid foundation.
All right. I don't know if I've preached that before.
Yeah.
Solid foundation.
Amen.
Yes. Oftentimes, we travel on the highway, we see signs that said construction zone ahead.
Mm-hmm.
Some of you are like me when we see that sign and it says reduce speed. We really don't reduce speed because we're comfortable traveling at the speed that we're traveling at. And we just keep on going at the regular speed unless we see flashing lights of a patrol vehicle. You see, each of us and every one of us is a like a work in progress.
Yes.
See, we all are a work in progress. And even when they finish highways or when they finish buildings, somehow they still have to always go back and do some touch-up. I remember when they finished this road out here, because I come here several times a day. When it was finished, one night they had the road blocked off. They had to go back and redo the asphalt. Mm-hmm. Anybody remember that?
Yeah.
So it's and so are we. We're like that. Sometimes God has to revisit our spiritual life and give us a spiritual makeup every now and then.
Yeah.
But so we all are a work in progress.
That's
and
right.
We are a construction zone in which we custom build our lives while we're working out our own salvation.
Amen.
I like to say that we're sending up our timber for that mansion being prepared for us by Jesus Christ day by day. And I like that old song, I'm sending up my timber every day. And the reason you're sending up your timber is because you're getting ready for that mansion that really don't need any more work. So as we build our lives, we have a choice in the contractors that we choose. One contractor may builds homes on solid foundation. And I come by to let you know that's the contractor I want to choose. I want that contractor, and that contractor is Jesus.
Yes.
Because he's going to build
my house and my life on a solid foundation. And then there's that other contractor that builds a house on shaky ground. And that contractor is Satan. See, so you don't want to have your house built by Satan. And if I were you today, I would make sure I choose the right contractor.
Yeah,
right.
And that contractor is the ones that build the house on a solid foundation. You see, my brothers and sisters, Jesus made Paul Peter when he was commissioned by Jesus, and Jesus told him about the foundation and then the rock. He was letting us know that the right foundation had to be laid for the church.
Yes.
And Jesus would build the church on a foundation that was made out of solid rock.
Yeah.
Even when he commissioned Peter in Matthew 16, he said, upon this rock, I will build my church. But then he added and said, and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. Even in that verse, we see the introduction of the two contractors. Y'all with me? Jesus represents the rock, and the gates of hell represents Satan.
All right.
Jesus knew that the devil would try to destroy the church.
Right.
Y'all hear me? I said he already knew.
Yes.
Why wouldn't he know it? Well, have we forgotten that the devil made his way into the Garden of Eden?
Yes.
Yes. Have we forgotten that he went to Jesus when he was on the mountain? And after he had fasted for 40 days, who showed up? The devil. And when Jesus was weak and hungry, he tried to tempt Jesus to bow down and worship him. And said that if you do this, you can have all the kingdoms of the world. But one thing that old devil didn't realize, and that old devil didn't know, Jesus already owned it. He already owned all the kingdoms. So he didn't need the devil. He didn't have to worship the devil to have the kingdom because he created the kingdom. He already had the power of the world in his hands. He didn't need the power from the devil because God had given him the power to build his church.
Amen.
And that's the message for the church tonight, that this scripture is not for the building inspector.
Yeah.
Y'all hear me?
Yes.
Or St. Cloud.
Yeah.
This message is not, the church is built not for the building inspector of Osceola County. We've been using building inspectors and this is not for the planning board in the county administration. This scripture is for the individual who make up the body of Christ, which is the church.
Yes.
And this scripture is to keep the devil out of this body, which is the temple of God.
Yes.
In order to keep the devil out, the church has to be built on a solid foundation.
Yes.
And remember, not this building. Not this building, because I can remember Brother Odom saying that y'all, this was once a wooden floor, and y'all brought in this concrete, and we have churches with wooden floors, and we have church with concrete floor. Well, the building inspector, if he was building a church, gonna make sure that you put in the right foundation. But Jesus, this body, you make up the body of Christ, so you got to make sure you. Have the right foundation. So when the scripture says in Matthew 16 and 18 that the gates of hell should not prevail against it, he already knew that the devil would infiltrate the church.
Yes.
He already knew that the devil